Peanut butter and traffic jams I've ever seen. Get it? Peanut butter, traffic.
Got it.
Gosh, maybe I should have used less peanut butter.
Okay, everybody, come on through.
Fuzzy?
I didn't?
Uh-uh. The plant must have fallen over because of the earthquake.
Earthquake?
Gee, Nanny, what is an earthquake?
Well, let's see. You see all the layers of soil that were underneath this plant?
Uh-huh.
Well, the earth has layers, too.
It does?
The top layer of the earth is called the crust.
Like bread crust?
That's right. And the very bottom layer is called the core.
Oh! You mean like an apple core, Nanny?
Well, sort of. Actually, it's more like a peach pit.
Peach pit? Apple core. Good earth.
Oh, no, animal. The core of the earth is very hot.
What?
Sometimes pressure builds up, and it has to be released.
Excuse me.
That's right, animal. An earthquake is kind of like a burp.
That's disgusting.
I know it isn't very pleasant, Piggy. But if the earth didn't release some pressure, it might explode.
Gee!
I'll go get the vacuum to clean up this mess.
Okay, Nanny.
Phil, I don't like it when the earth burps.
But, Piggy, Nanny said if the earth didn't burp, it might explode.
I don't care. Someone should teach the earth some manners.
Manners? Who's going to do that, Piggy?
Someone with excellent manners, like moi.
Oh.
Oh, excuse me.
No, no, excuse me.
Well, that's a little better. Oh, looky, Kermit. Giant mushroom. Oh, no, not you too.
Excuse me. I'm really very... Sorry.
That's better.
Now listen, my young friend. We all have to release a little pressure now and again.
Excuse me.
This is so disgusting!
Come on, Piggy, we better go. There, now isn't that better?
Yes, Kermit, and at least these rocks and hills aren't burping.
Rocks burp.
Animal, what are you doing here?
Contest, contest.
What?
Excuse me.
Burp, burp.
Pardon me.
Butter burp.
Oh, pardon me.
Best burp.
That's it. Right this minute. Don't you think you have any manners?
Sorry.
That's better.
Here's the vacuum, and I brought something to show you.
Oh, boy.
What is it, Nanny?
I think this picture might help you understand earthquakes better.
Oh, let me see.
Look.
See? The earth is like a great big ball. The top layer is called...
I know. The crust.
That's right. Then there is a layer of hard rock and another layer called the outer core.
And then the pit, right, Nanny?
Right. But it's really called the inner core, Scooter. And that's where all the pressure builds up.
Gosh!
I'll leave the book here so you can look at it.
Thanks, Nanny.
Wow, this book is neato. Come on, guys.
Careful!
Gee, I just gotta get these skates off, but I need my skate key.
Gee, Fozzie, it sounded like your key fell down through all the layers of the earth, maybe even to the core.
Come on, guys. Maybe we'll find another skate key while we clean up this mess.
Right.
Oh, sure.
Gosh, you really think my key fell all the way to the earth's core, Skeeter?
No way, Fozzie. It probably just got stuck somewhere in the earth's crust.
Hey, you guys, I figured out how we can get inside the earth to find Fozzie's skate key.
Really?
Yeah.
How?
How can we do that?
Yeah, how?
Just step inside. Going down?
Gee, Gonzo, what a great idea.
I don't think it's so great. I don't believe this.
Don't worry about a thing, Piggy, my sweet. I've got everything under control.
That's what I'm afraid of.
Watch your step, please. First up, boulders, pebbles, and... Oh, boy, rock creatures.
Gonzo, close the door.
Close door, close door.
Pardon me, but may I help you with something?
Well, we were looking for a lost skate key.
A skate key?
Yeah, it went down the vent during the earthquake.
Earthquake?
Yeah! Come on, let's get out of here.
Gee, Gonzo, that rock creature was a bigger chicken than you.
Oh, me? I wasn't scared.
Gonzo... That was just the elevator bell.
Oh, yeah. Where are we now?
It looks like we're on the edge of the rock layer, Piggy. Wow, this is cool.
Hey, Maynard. This, we've got company.
Yeah, dig it, Miles.
Hey, what's a bunch of nice babies like you doing in a place like this? You must be miles from home, right, Maynard?
Miles.
Well, we lost the key. Have you seen it?
A key? How about B-flat?
Ooh, sharp, Miles, like in off-key.
Not that kind of key. A skate key. Fuzzy lost his skate key.
I'm afraid we don't play in that key, man.
Oh, gosh. I'm never gonna find my key.
Sure you will, Fozzie. We just have to keep looking. Even if we have to go all the way to the earth's core.
You're heading for the center of the earth? You are crazy, man.
Yeah, crazy, man.
Business. It's wild down there.
Yeah, pretty uncool.
Yeah, like hot
for the warning, but we really have to find Fozzie's key. Come on, guys.
Okay.
Maynard, those little dudes are gonna need help.
Boy, Maynard and Miles sure were far out.
I don't like this. They said it was wild down inside the Earth.
And hot.
Yeah, wild and hot.
Gonzo, thank you to open the door.
What's your hurry?
Gonzo, open the door!
Okay, okay!
Welcome, dear friends.
Oh, boy.
Hurt you.
Oh.
You'll make excellent workers for my salt mines.
No, no.
Listen here, mister. Whoever you are, what if we say no?
Then I'll let my robot soldiers use you for target practice.
Oh, no problem. We love working in salt mines, right, guys?
Yeah, we don't even mind pepper.
Fuzzy?
How fortunate. Come with me.
But we'll have to be sure and tank him when we get there. Get it?
Fozzie!
Sorry.
Ew, what are those?
Salt miners.
Good shot. Sir, I'm a seasoned professional.
Wow, that's so weird.
Yeah, isn't it great?
Where are we?
Ah, the pepper mills.
Huh?
Time for you to go to work.
Gee, wow.
Oh, Kermy, what are we gonna do?
GP, I guess we start picking.
Here, man, I put these on your schnozzles.
Miles? Maynard? Is that you?
Dig it.
Hey, everybody, look, it's a
man, be cool. We figured you were in for some trouble, so we came to play this rescue gig. Come on.
Hey, isn't it the way back to the elevator?
Relax, man. This is what you call a shortcut. Ding.
Huh? Okay.
Relax, man.
You're getting closer.
Here's your elevator shaft, man.
Oh, boy.
Let's go. Miles, where's the elevator?
Whoa, sorry, man. I can't think of everything. Well, like my daddy always says, if you want to get down,
you gotta get down.
Crazy.
Is everyone okay?
Yeah. Hey, what happened to Miles and Maynard?
Oh, wow.
Are you okay?
Yeah, but I think it's time for us to take five.
Five? Why can't we all go?
Five?
Oh, painful, man.
Hey, guys, where are we anyway?
Hey, man, you made it. You're at the center of the Earth. Later.
Oh, boy, let's find my skate key. Come on, guys. You okay, Fozzie? Boy, oh, Willie, is it hot in here?
It must be too much pressure. Gotta find me a new job.
What?
Uh-oh, I better take care of that one. I don't want things to get out of control around here. Oh, let's see, I got that one. Oh, maybe now I can take a little breather. Oh, damn it! Here we go again. Whoa, I need a vacation.
Gee, do you think
Keith see my steak, Keith?
Maybe we should ask him.
Yeah. Go ahead, come and ask him.
Huh? Oh, boy. Excuse me, sir.
What is it? I mean, well, hold on a minute, Sonny. I'm busy. Plum busy. Now, what do you want?
Well, Mr.
Edgar.
What?
My name's Edgar. Puddin' came, asked me again, and I'll tell you the same.
Huh? Oh, well, Mr. Edgar, I was just wondering if you've seen a skate key around here.
Skate key? Now, what in tarnation would I be doing with a skate key? Do I look like I'm having fun?
Well, it fell into the fence in our nursery after one of your earthquakes.
What? My earthquakes? Don't you pin these things on me. I'm just doing my job.
Oh, gotta release this darn pressure all over the globe so we don't have the big one.
You see, kids, if we didn't have these earthquakes, volcanoes, and stuff, the whole darn planet might, well, come apart at the seams.
Gee, just like Nanny said.
But earthquakes are scary.
Well, they scare me, too. But there's a few things you can do to be safer in an earthquake.
Like what?
Well, for starters, look around the house. See, there you go. And make sure there's nothing heavy up high to fall and conk you on the head.
Ooh, like that.
I can't turn my back on this job for a second. Oh, boy, it's a four-alarmer. Well, don't just stand there. Huh? Well, make yourself useful.
What?
Well, pull those levers, quick.
But Mr. Edgar, we're too short.
Yeah. Hey, Bobby can reach because his skates make him taller.
Good work, Bear. Now get those over there.
Come on, guys, let's have it.
By golly, I knew you could do it!
Yeah, Poppy!
You did a great job!
Well, you can say that again. In fact, I'm gonna order me a pair of those skates.
Really? Oh, gee.
Well, I'm sure sorry we didn't find your key, youngster.
Yeah, me too. Come on, guys. We better go.
Well, bye, kids. Now you take care, you hear?
Oh, no. There's still no elevator.
Hey, Mr. Edgar! Can you help us get back to the surface?
No problem!
Whoa, what a ride!
Yeah.
Hi, kids. Fuzzy, are you still looking for a skate key? Well, guess what? I found my old skate key in a kitchen drawer.
Great. Thanks, Nanny.
Nanny, we want to make the nursery earthquake-proof.
Yeah, we want to take down all the heavy stuff so it won't conk us on the head.
Well, what a great idea. Tell you what, let's have some lunch, and then I'll help you make the whole house safer for earthquakes.
Take a chair that talks, a robot that walks, a red bow tie, and a wacky guy. And you've got...
Playhouse Guy! Yippee!
All new really neat fun stuff at Pee-wee's Playhouse. Coming up next.
Oops. Uh-oh.